Hello everybody, I'm Satyam Gupta from Bennett University and I'm here to discuss about a blog I've recently written which discusses about predicting a pulsar star using different machine learning algorithms. Before starting, let me brief you about what a pulsar star is. Pulsars are a rare type of neutron stars that produce radio emissions detectable here on the Earth. As the pulsars rotate, they emit detectable pattern of broadband radio emissions. And as they rotate rapidly, these patterns also repeat themselves periodically. Thus, pulsar research involves looking for periodic radio signals with large radio telescopes. Each pulsar produces a slightly different emission pattern, which varies slightly with each rotation. Thus, a potential signal detection known as a candidate is averaged over many rotations of the pulsar as determined by the length of an observation. In the absence of additional information which should be accurate enough, each candidate could be potentially described as a real pulsar. However, in practice, almost all the detections caused by radio frequency interference and noise, making the legitimate signals hard to find. Thus, we use machine learning tools to detect and label pulsar candidates to facilitate our rapid analysis. We'll be using supervised machine learning. What supervised machine learning is? In general, supervised learning occurs when a system is given input and output variables with the intentions of learning how they are mapped together. And the goal is to produce an accurate enough mapping function that when the new input is given, the algorithm can predict the output. This is an iterative process and each time the algorithm makes a prediction, it is corrected or given feedback until it achieves an acceptable level of accuracy. We'll be using classification algorithms. Classification algorithms classify the data into their respective labels. When we provide the training data, we provide the data with their labels and the model learns from it. And thus, we provide the testing data without the labels and the model classifies them into their respective labels. We can use different classification models like logistic regression, decision tree, random forest, etc. Now let's have a look at dataset. We use the dataset provided by the Kaggle website. The dataset shared here contains about 16,000 spurious examples, in which about 1,700 are the real pulsar examples. Each row lists a variable first. The class labels used are 0 for the negative and 1 for the positive. Each candidate is described by 8 continuous variables and a single class variable. The first 4 are the simple statistics obtained from the integrated pulse profile. It is an array of continuous variables that describe a longitude resolved version of the signal that has been averaged in both time and frequency. The remaining 4 variables similarly obtained from the dispersion medium signal to noise ratio curve. As you can see, these are the attributes. Which are of decimal data type and the class is of integer binary data type, 0 for negative and 1 for the positive. Now let's start by importing the necessary libraries. We import pandas for data manipulation and analysis, the matplotlib for the data visualization, numpy for mathematical transformations, seaborn for heat map, and sklearn for machine learning algorithm. Then we load the dataset into the pandas data frame. This is what our dataset looks like. As you can see, the 8 of the attributes are of decimal data types and target class is of binary integer. Data preprocessing. Why do we need data preprocessing? When we collect data from various sources, it is of raw format. And to feed the data into the machine learning models, we need them to be of specific formats. The dataset we collect from various sources can have many null values and thus we can use pre-processing techniques like missing value imputation for that. Also, the range of the data can be too large and we need to scale it down. We can use the scaling technique for that. And sometimes we need to normalize the data into a desired distribution. We can use normalization and standardization techniques for the same. All the values are specified and we don't have any null values, so we don't need any missing value imputation. Correlation. It is a way to find how an attribute is related to another feature. We can visualize the same using the heat map. This is the heat map depicting correlation between attributes. We do not find any correlation between the attributes. Splitting the dataset. We have divided the whole dataset into 75% for the training set and 25% for the testing set. Logistic regression. Logistic regression algorithm uses a linear equation with independent predictors to predict a value. We use logistic regression for classification. This is the logistic regression function, and via predict one is the output. Evaluating the model. We are using accuracy score for evaluation. Accuracy score is the ratio of number of correct predictions to the number of input samples. As you can see, the accuracy for this logistic regression is 0.98, which is quite good. Decision tree classifier. A decision tree is a flowchart-like tree structure where an internal node represents feature, the branch represents a decision rule, and each leaf node represents the outcome. Decision tree classifier used here is a function, and ViaPred2 is the predicted outcome. Evaluating, the accuracy is 0.97, which is very good. Random forest classifier. Random forest classifier creates a set of decision trees from randomly selected subsets of training set. This is the code. And here we have used 45 N estimators for the same. The accuracy is 0.983, which again is very good. Support vector machine. A support vector machine is a discriminative classifier formally defined by a separating hyperplane. Since the data is not linear, so we have to use the RBF kernel. ViaPredict4 is the predicted outcome of support vector machine, and the accuracy is 0.92. This is the comparison of accuracy scores of all the models we have used. And by seeing, we can say the random forest classifier with 45 N estimators worked the best with an accuracy of 0.983 for a dataset. So this blog was an attempt to explain the various classification algorithms that can be used to predict a pulsating star. The attributes selected were quite relevant to the model with an effective range of values, thus giving us a great accuracy without the need of data preprocessing techniques like normalization, scaling, missing value imputation, etc. Since the accuracy score was quite good, we don't need to use the regularization techniques too. Thank you.